Welcome to the second lesson. We're going to go over three topics in this video: expressions, data types, and variables. Go ahead and start idle, which is the editor that comes installed with Python. On Windows, click on the start button, type idle, and I have multiple versions of Python installed on my computer, but I'm just going to use idle that comes with Python 3.5. The course notes describe how to start idle if you have Mac or Linux. Idle has two parts: the interactive shell. And if you click on File, New File, the file editor will appear. The interactive shell runs Python instructions one at a time and shows you the results immediately. It's great for just experimenting and seeing what instructions do. The file editor lets you enter Python code for complete programs. There are other editor apps for typing in Python programs. I use one called Sublime Text, and there's another one called PyCharm. But this course will use idle because it comes with Python and there's no additional setup to do, and because it's the same across Mac, Windows, and Linux. Now, the interactive shell and file editor windows look really similar, so it's easy to get them confused, but you can always tell the difference because the interactive shell will have the triple angle bracket prompt. In this lesson, we'll be entirely focused on the interactive shell, so close the file editor for now. Let's begin by typing a simple Python instruction. Type 2 plus 2, and then press enter. In Python, 2 plus 2 is called an expression. It's the most basic kind of programming instruction in the Python language. Expressions consist of values, such as the 2s, and operators, such as the plus. Expressions always evaluate, that is, they always reduce, down to a single value. So in this example, 2 plus 2 is evaluated down to a single value, 4. You can even think of the single value by itself as an expression. The expression 2 evaluates to itself, 2. There are several other types of operators we can try out. Type the following: 5 minus 3, which does subtraction and evaluates to 2. 3 times 7, which does multiplication and evaluates to 21. Note that multiplication is done with the asterisk and not the x. If you tried to type something like 3x7, Python would just give you an error. For division, we use the forward slash, so 22 divided by 7 evaluates to 3.14. And there are a few other less common math operators, so check the course notes for them. Now, order of operation rules apply here. Multiplication and division are done first, then addition and subtraction. But you can use parentheses to override the usual precedence if you need to. So let's look at two similar expressions. 2 plus 3 times 6, which evaluates to 20, and then type 2 plus 3 in parentheses times 6, which evaluates to 30. So I have a visualization tool so that we can see how Python evaluates expressions step by step. In 2 plus 3 times 6, the multiplication is done first. So 3 times 6 evaluates to 18. Then 2 plus 18 evaluates to 20. Well, the parentheses overrides the multiplication, so 2 plus 3 is done first, and a value just in parentheses by itself just evaluates to the value, and then 5 times 6 evaluates to 30. No matter how big the expression is, Python evaluates it until it becomes a single value. Let's use this expression as an example. Open paren, 5 minus 1, close paren, times, open paren, 7 plus 1, close paren, divided by, open paren, 3 minus 1, close paren. No matter how complicated an expression is, all expressions are just values and operators, and it always evaluates down to a single value. You can see this step by step in the visualization tool. And 7 plus 1 evaluates to 8. 3 minus 1 then evaluates, and then the operation inside the parenthesis evaluates, and then finally it evaluates down to 16. All of these expressions evaluate to the same thing. You can copy and paste any of these, and they evaluate to the same value. If you type something that Python can't understand, it'll display an error message. So let's trigger one of those in idle right now. type 5 plus and press enter. You can always test to see whether an instruction works by typing it in the interactive shell. These errors don't damage the computer. Don't worry. Professional software developers get error message while writing code all the time, so don't think that you've messed anything up. All values have a data type. A data type is a category of values, and every value belongs to exactly one data type. So whole number values like negative 2 and 30, for example, are integers. Numbers with a decimal point, such as 3.14, are called floating point numbers. We also call integer values and floating point values ints and floats, for short. Note that even though 42 is an integer, 42.0 is a float. So there's also a data type for text values. These are called strings. When typing strings, begin and end them with a single quote so Python knows where the text begins and ends. For example, type, quote, hello world, and quote. And when the plus operator is used on strings, it's the string concatenation operator. Concatenation means joins the strings together. For example, let's type Alice plus string Bob. And this expression evaluates down to the single string Alice Bob. Less common is the multiplication operator for string replication, which operates on an integer and a string. This is handy if you have to make a string repeat itself. You can type in the string Alice times 3 to create the string Alice, Alice, Alice. Or try this expression, which uses string concatenation and replication. The string hello plus the string exclamation mark times 10. And that will evaluate to a string value that has hello with 10 exclamation marks after it. Your programs can save values to the computer's memory with variables. A variable is kind of like a box that can store a single value. You can do this with an assignment statement. In the interactive shell, enter spam equals 42. Now this creates a new variable named spam and stores the value 42 inside of it. So you can think of it as a box with the label spam and it has the value 42 in it. And normally you would give variables names that describe the data they contain. Imagine if you were moving and you labeled all of your boxes stuff. That wouldn't be too helpful. But for these lessons, we just need a generic name. So the words spam, eggs, bacon, and ham are often used in Python tutorials because of the spam comedy sketch from Monty Python.
Egg, bacon, sausage, and spam! Spam, bacon, sausage, and spam! Spam, egg, spam, spam, bacon, and spam! Spam, 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 egg, and spam! Spam,
You can use variables and expressions anywhere you would normally use values. A variable just evaluates to the value it contains. So when I type spam, that evaluates to 42. So in the interactive shell, type spam equals hello. That will store the string hello in the variable spam. Now when we have the expression spam plus world, Well, Python does exactly what we tell it to, which is why it doesn't have a space in between these words. Let's try that again. Spam plus, and then world with a space in front of it. There we go. So this is just regular string concatenation, because spam evaluates down to the string inside of it, and then that gets concatenated with the world string. Additional assignment statements can change the value that's inside the variable. The old value is forgotten. This is called overwriting the variable. So I could set spam to a new value, such as goodbye. This same spam plus world expression evaluates to a different value. So you can think of the old value is just being tossed out and forgotten, and the new value being assigned every time we have an assignment statement. Expressions are one kind of instruction in Python. The other kind are statements. Unlike expressions, statements don't evaluate to a single value. Although an assignment statement can have an expression as part of itself. Let's try typing spam equals 2 plus 2. The 2 plus 2 expression evaluates to 4, and so 4 is the value that gets assigned to spam. We can even use the variable itself to set the variable's new value. Try typing spam equals 10, and then spam equals spam plus 1. This assigns spam a new value. The new value for spam is equal to the current value of spam plus 1. Spam, 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 variable, spam. So, if a Python instruction evaluates to a single value, it's an expression. Otherwise, it's a statement. But mostly we just generically call them instructions or code. To recap, IDLE is the editor program that you type code into. It has two parts, the interactive shell, which runs code one instruction at a time, and the file editor, where you will type complete programs into. Expressions are made up of values and operators, and they always evaluate down to one value. And every value belongs to exactly one data type. The data types we've seen so far are integers, floating point numbers, and strings. And strings contain text, and they start and end with a single quote character. And values can be stored in variables, which can then be used in expressions anywhere values are used.